and welcome to another episode of FooBar. In today's episode, we are going to talk about AppRunner and how you can build that service using the AWS CDK. Last week, I showed you an intro to what is AppRunner, and basically we agreed that it's the child that Lambda and Fargate had. It's a service that allows you to deploy applications without needing to worry about infrastructure. It doesn't scale to zero, but it's quite cheap to use, and you don't need to worry about infrastructure, so it has the best of everything. In this video, we are going to grab an existing Node.js application, and we are going to deploy it with AppRunner, building the whole infrastructure, and then getting it to the cloud. The app I'm going to use for this demo is the app that we have been working with in the lift and shift to serverless migration. If you don't know what is this app, I have made 11 videos around this topic. We graph an existing application that was built with, I have here the architecture, it's a Node.js Express backend application. We have migrated the database that was using Mongo to Mongo Atlas, so that is in the cloud, and we have put the web application, the React.js application using Simplify. So I have built all this application and all the migration and all the steps and why we have done everything into this series of 11 videos. And the bit on the server side where we have this Node.js Express app, we put it in Lambda using the Lambda web adapter. So now I'm going to grab that application, and instead of putting it in Lambda, I will put it in AppRunner. When you go into the link I will leave you in the description, there is the backend migration here, and I say that one of the options is to use AppRunner. And the reason why I didn't pick it is because our migration requirement was to scale to zero, and AppRunner didn't allow us to scale to zero. But if we remove that migration requirement, AppRunner works very well. So the application is in this project. I will link the project in the description box. It's the whole application that we migrated. I just basically grab it and put it into its own GitHub project so we can use it with AppRunner. So here you will find, oh, it's a standard Node.js Express app, and here you find the application with its controllers, middlewares, everything. It's not containerized. This is just an Express Node app that you just put in your app computer and run npm run backend, and boom, it puts it up. So this is the application, and this is how it looks. This is the front end. It's deploying Simplify, and the backend now is running in AppRunner. I will show you how you do it in this video. Here you can see we open the products. We can then we have login and logout using Cognito. Everything is explained in that blog post. Here we have the different items. We can purchase them. We can see the history of purchases and everything like that. And this is running in this AppRunner service here. And we can see the metrics of this running. You can see here that we have some requests. This is me clicking through. We can see that everything is good. We can see that we have some active instances and so on and so forth. That's good. So how we build this? Let's go into the code. The code is also public. It will be the link in the description box. And when I build this application, I decided to build a stack per solution. So for the front end, I have the Simplify stack. For the back end, I had a Lambda stack. And now I changed it to the AppRunner stack. So this is the only change I'm doing in this application. I'm replacing that stack where I was building the Lambda function into using AppRunner. So in here, I'm going to have this stack that is the AppRunner stack. I'm going to be using the level one constructor for AppRunner, as the level two constructor, that is a more simplified version of AppRunner, is in alpha. And I want to use a little bit more features that the alpha constructor provides. For example, the alpha constructor doesn't have automatic deployments, and I wanted that. So I'm using the level one constructor that resembles quite a lot to CloudFormation. So let's look at how we define this service. The first thing I'm going to do is to put a name. And then we have different configurations. We have the source configuration and the instance configuration. Let's look at the source configuration here, and we can look at the different bits and pieces. The first one is the authentication configuration, and here I need to define the connection ARN. This one, I have it as an environmental variable in my project, so you can go and check the config here, and it will be added here. It's not yet added, and the example is in the official one, but that one I'm trying to use. But basically, that will link you to the connection. What we'll do is connect your GitHub repo to AppRunner, so whenever you do a push, this can work and you can see the repositories and you can interact with the repositories similar as you do with Amplify. So that's what we will do from the authentication configuration. Then we have auto deployments enable, and what this means is that means that whenever we do a new commit into our GitHub repo, this will trigger build and deploy the new version of the application. The good thing, because AppRunner is using canary deployments, whenever we are deploying a new version of the application, the service will be available, so there is no need to worry about unavailability of the service. So if something is being deployed, it will be rolled out when it's completely deployed and everything is launched. Then in the code repository part, we have the code configuration, and here you can see the configuration values. And this is quite a bit. The first command is the start command. This is the command that you will use from your machine to start your application. So I will run npm run backend, and that's how I will run it. Then I will have the build command. In my case, I will run npm I install, and that will run in which port is initializing the runtime. And this is because my application is not containerized, so it needs to build it and deploy it. If it was a containerized application, you don't need this configuration. Also, if you are running a non-containerized application, there is some runtimes that are available. It's not in all the runtimes you can do this. So check the documentation if your runtime is available. Then we have some secrets, and secrets are important. This is connecting to secret manager for finding my Mongo connection string. So this one I need to pass, and I'm getting that one from here. So this is the secret. I have created this secret in the secret manager. I have uploaded my Mongo URI, and I'm getting the secret here, and I'm passing it the secret ARN here. Then I'm passing environmental variables. Environmental variables are very important. In this case, my backend needs them to do some cognito validation to make sure that the users are validated, to validate access tokens, and so on and so forth. So I'm passing cognito identity pool and cognito client ID, so we can do this. And then these ones are going to be available in my application. Then we have this configuration source API. There is other option. If you select the API, you're going to do the configurations in here. If you select the source option, I think it's the other option, you are going to have in your root of your project a file that says AppRunner, and here you're going to configure your project. So similar as you will do with Amplify, that you have an Amplify YAML in the root of your React app, for example, we're going to do all the configurations on how you're going to build, on how you're going to connect the environmental variables. Similar is with AppRunner, so you can choose how to do it. Then you're going to pass the URL. If you're using the repository way, you're going to pass the URL of the repository. In my case, it's this one, and I have it as a configuration variable. If you have using ECRs, you need to pass the image Amazon resource name, image ARN. So instead of repository URL, it will be a different parameter. And then if you're using a repository URL, you need to pass in which branch your code is. In this case, my branch is main. And if I will have multiple stages, I might have more branches here. Then we have the instance configuration, and here is where I will define the amount of CPUs and memory I want. I will not do it. I will go with the default one virtual CPU and I think 2 GB of memory, but you can define that. And then I'm giving a role to my instance so it have access to do things. As in AWS, things are born without permissions, and the same happens with instances in AppRunner. So in this case, this instance has only one policy that is giving permissions to access the secret, because it needs the secret and it needs to have permissions to access the secret. So I need to give that permission. Later on, when we start building more things on AppRunner, I will need to give different permissions to do things. And that's it. That's the whole thing for AppRunner. So how I'm doing it, I have this main file where all the stacks are getting created, and here I'm creating the app runner. I'm passing the stage, I'm passing the two Cognito values that it needs as environmental variables that I'm creating the Cognito stack, and then boom, it's building my app runner service. Then for this application to work, for building the frontend, I'm passing the server URL to Amplify as an environmental variable. So you can see it when the Amplify is being built. We can go to environmental variables, and here is the app runner endpoint. So then the backend will connect there. So we can see here, for example, let's refresh and let's see here, get history is connecting to the app runner. Because this application is using, is a web app with a backend, you need to have enabled cores in order to this cross domain to work. So have that in mind. My application is doing it in the server. I have a core library, so don't forget that, because Lambda web adapter will handle cores for you, but AppRunner doesn't. So set up that, I have it here. Then I have a stack for observability. If you have no idea what I'm building here, I have a whole video on how to build these CloudWatch dashboards. So I have built one, CloudWatch, here you find it. I built one for this project a long time ago when I built the Lift and Shift project. We built the CloudWatch dashboard, and in there, they were showing some Lambda information. Now I changed it to show some app runner information. So you can see here the amount of active instances, and you can see here the request and responses with the different types of errors. You can see that one, I have the instances twice. And then you can see the latency here, and all that is in the observability stack. And here you can see how I'm grabbing the different metrics. For app runner, I'm passing the name, service name, and service ID as variables in order to build these things. So that's something you can do. So one thing you can do is to run load test. For that, we can use Artillery. I have here a couple of scripts, the Artillery and the simple script that does different things in my APIs, and you can see how this performs. If you want to compare it with the Lambda, you can. We can run it by basically running this command. I will leave the video on Artillery and how to use it in the comments. But basically, Artillery is a library that allows you to do load test in the cloud. In this case, it's used Lambda as a place where requests and all the operations are happening, so it doesn't impact your computer. And I'm running this script against AppRunner. It's running in Lambda in this region, so it will take a while and it will start running this test in the cloud. And we can see the results in a moment. Also here you can grab that endpoint and run it with Postman. You don't need to have a front end and just do some operations. In this case, I'm getting a product, and you can see the list of products that the application replies. The endpoint is usable from many places, so that's something you can play with. So when you're running those load tests, you can start seeing in the dashboards how that is impacting your app runner instances and the amount of requests and response and so on. So I will let the load test run for a little bit and we'll be back and see what is happening here. So we are back. The load test finished. It throw 10,000 requests, and here you can see the response times, a minimum 4 seconds and then to 3,000 something, and the median is quite good, 4 milliseconds, this much milliseconds, 3,000 something, then the median is 10 milliseconds, P95 30 and P99 68. So it's not that bad. There are some outliers there, but there's always some. So we can see the dashboard. So here we have the dashboard of the Amplify request and the backend request. So here we can see what is going on. So let's look at AppRunner. I fixed this graph a little bit so it shows us the real value, because this is updating every minute and sometimes the measurements is not that good. When there is no measurements, it just drops. So here I make it a little bit bigger, the window in minutes. So it shows that there is one active instance, so that's good. And here we can see the amount of requests and response. We can see that there were in total almost 3,000 requests every minute. So we had over 10,000 requests, so it adds up quite easily, but that doesn't mean that it will increase the amount of requests of instances. So even though we have a maximum here, we can see in our configuration of 100 concurrent requests, because the requests finish so fast, that doesn't mean that they will spin more instances. So because my requests finish very fast, that doesn't require more instances. So it can take a big load. And here we can see the latency, so we can see how long this request takes to fulfill. So we have one that it takes 92, this is the P95, in this minute it took 92 milliseconds. We can also add here if we want the maximum and minimum, so let's, we can see here maximum in 1 minute, and we can see how this changes if there is some difference. So for example, it's a similar, because in a minute it's 92. So this is how it looks. And that's the video for me today. If you want to try this out, the code is in the description box. If you try the AppRunner, don't forget either to destroy this stack after you finish, or you can pause this, because these are not serverless services, so they will incur costs even if you are not using it. And with that, I say thank you for watching. If you want to know more about the lift and shift and how I build this app, the playlist is in here, as well as more on AppRunner, the video is here, so you can go and learn more. And I see you in another episode of FooBar. Ciao, ciao!